Volatility this week after mixed reports from the U.S. and Chinese governments about trade progress heading into the final stretch of the year. Reuters reporting both sides are asking for more extensive tariff rollbacks as part of a phase one deal. And joining us now is Melissa Armo, founder and owner of the stock Swoosh. It's so great to have you on the show, Melissa. We are getting pretty darn close to that December 15th tariff deadline. How big of a setback could this be for trade negotiations if we actually reach December 15th and tariffs are implemented?
Well, I think it's going to be very interesting because remember back in October, they were supposed to implement more tariffs and then Trump decided to wait on that. As long as these talks continue, I don't think they're going to put the tariffs on. That being said, I think at some point, this deal is going to fall through in the phase that it's at right now. Like they're acting like they're going to ink this deal and sign it soon. I never thought that was going to happen. I didn't think that was going to happen since January. I did not think a deal would get any part of the deal. Not only a complete deal, but any piece of the deal, which they're talking about, I didn't think would happen in 2019. And there's several reasons that I think that. One, the presidential elections is coming up in 2020. My thoughts are that China may want to wait it out and see if Trump really wins re-election. And number two, right now at this point, as long as China can keep pushing off new tariffs, well, they're going to leave it be as it stands. And so far, the Trump administration has been trying to work and do that. So there's no reason to think that they wouldn't push them back for December as well, just like they did in October, as long as they're talking.
Even though we do see it drastically impacting the economy in the world's biggest and second biggest economy, China and the U.S., that is. Melissa, how do you trade this, that view that you have? How do you trade that?
I think it's very interesting because every time the market has looked like it's going to drop off, it hasn't. I mean, we have made more record-breaking highs in Trump's presidency than any other presidency ever in the history of the United States. And there's no denying that. Whether you like Trump, whether you don't like Trump, I mean, the fact is that you can't deny the strength in the market. The market's getting bought. Now, that's not to say that it's going to keep going up forever. A lot of people, though, have missed this rally because they keep waiting for a pullback. I think there's a possibility, and I'm not saying 100%, but I'm saying there's a possibility that we could see a big one more big move with a big fat green bar over the high sometime soon. Soon meaning the next couple of days or the next couple of weeks before the end of the year. And then after that, you might see volatility in the later part of 2019 because of the trade deals, which means we could fall off at that point. But right now, you can't deny the strength in the market. There's no way to short this and profit.
Okay, well, let's say that President Trump doesn't end up signing a phase one trade deal by the end of the year and no big trade deal is reached before the 2020 election. How do you avoid the uncertainty that executives are feeling about trade from seeping into uncertainty for the consumer? As we know, the consumer powers this economy.
I think the consumer's gotten used to it. You've seen that in a lot of the retail earnings, specifically Target. Target had record-breaking earnings this week. And Target's a good example of that. Usually, we're getting into the Black Friday 1 week from today. Usually, you see a lot of these stores have the biggest part of their year in the second half of the year. But you've seen stores like Target, they had great earnings back earlier in the year. They have great earnings now again in the last week. These are these Target, Lowe's, Walmart, these are the places that regular everyday Americans shop, not rich people, but just regular everyday Americans that buy stuff. So again, you say to yourself, okay, well, if people are going out and shopping, then they're not feeling the pinch. They're feeling optimistic. They're happy when they see their 401ks. Everyone's 401ks, if you have one, has been increasing just by doing nothing. People are making money as far as the 401ks go in their retirement. So there's an optimistic attitude. And so when you look at that, you say, well, the consumers are not feeling the pinch. Even if they paid more for any products or services that have tariffs on already, you're not seeing it in their spending.
Melissa, very quickly, a new wave for Nordstrom, yes or no? The stock up 8% after earnings this morning.
I was looking up the Nordstrom here. I didn't look at that. I was looking at Foot Locker because Foot Locker is tanking
right now.
So Foot Locker is tanking because Foot Locker was actually up this morning a little bit in the pre-market, and then all of a sudden, shoot, it went like and tanked. Now let's just look at,
There Nordstrom. Is a lot of volatility in the retail. Go ahead, quickly.
Yeah. Nordstrom is up. However, I would not buy this here today. Looking at this here, it's up. It is up $3 plus from last night, but I wouldn't buy it here today. Nordstrom is one of those ones where it's kind of like could Nordstrom has to save itself because it's competing. Or remember, Nordstrom is luxury.
Right.
So this is a different sector compared to the Targets of the world. Mm-hmm. You're better off investing if you want to invest in
Melissa, we got to leave it there. Running up against the opening bell. Melissa Armo, founder and owner of the Stock Swoosh. Always great to see you. Thanks for joining us.